الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has beautiful names, and among them, when we go straight to the point today, is Al-Aziz. Al-Aziz. Why does he call himself Al-Aziz? What's the actual meaning of the name? The conqueror, the sovereign, the most powerful, the honorable, and the incomparable. Allahu Akbar. Look at how strong the name is. It gives you chills and goosebumps, honestly. What does this entail? In Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about those who would take as allies the non-believers. الَّذِينَ يَتَّخِذُونَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِن دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Those who would take the disbelievers, those who denied and rejected the message as allies other than the believers. What does he ask? أَيَبْتَغُونَ عِنْدَهُمُ الْعِزَّةِ. Are they to seek honor from them? فَإِنَّ الْعِزَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Honor, power, and sovereignty belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. All of it encompassing every type of power and might. It is all for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many leaders that we know, they are sovereign, they have strength, they have positions, and they have the capabilities to do things that we cannot even comprehend. But there's one thing that they lack. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only is He sovereign and the most powerful and strong, He is honorable at the same time. He holds His position like that. Why so? Because if you look at Surah Hud, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was addressing the Hud nation with their brother Salih, Salih alayhi salam was talking to them in regards to worshipping one God. And when the miracle of the camel was brought to them, what did they do? They hamstring the camel, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. And what did He say? إِنَّ رَبَّكَ هُوَ الْقَوِيُّ الْعَزِيزِ. Look at the tie between قَوِي and the word عَزِيز. Indeed, your Lord, هُوَ, and this is an affirmation, He is the most strong, Al-Aziz, honorable, incomparable, and sovereign. He did this out of His strength, out of His might, and out of His position with honor. And nobody can be the same as Allah. What do we benefit from this name? If we know that we are in a position where we perhaps are standing on a parliament, or perhaps we're standing where there is a judge, or perhaps we are somewhere, we are being judged, or something is going on which is against us, and we know that we are on the right, and everyone else can see that we are the ones who deserve to get the right verdict and deserve to be on the right side. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one we can return to, the one who is Al-Aziz. Not human beings and no one else, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because there is no one who is just enough and the most honorable than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For a fact, we know Allah alone is the one that we can rely on with full confidence, knowing that He is the one to give us justice, and the one who is the most powerful, and the one who would give it with honor and pride. To Allah we should rely.